Can you pass me a mini cheddar, love? I just want a mini cheddar from ya. Can you pass me a mini cheddar, love? I just want a mini cheddar, just want a mini cheddar. Just one little mini cheddar, all I ask. Just one little mini cheddar for your dad. Can you pass me a mini cheddar, love? I just want a mini cheddar, just want a mini cheddar. Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. My day is made, my life is made.
I know. What colour's your balloon, Fen?
Green.
What colour's your balloon, Bez?
Pink. Then they've got stars on them.
How many stars do they have on them, Fen?
Three. They've got lots of stars in them. Grandma gave them to me.
Why, what, how, or when? This is Waltz with Bess and Fen. Oh, this is Waltz with Bess and Fen. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say it's all right. Little darling, it's been a long and lonely winter. Little darling, it feels like years since you've been here. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say it's alright. Little darling, the smile's returning to the faces. Little darling, it feels like years since you've been here. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right. Little darling, I feel the ice is slowly melting. Little darling, it seems like years since it's been clear. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say it's alright. Here comes the sun. Here comes the sun, and I say, it's all right.
Look at that. Look what I'm making.
What is the most
colour?
Black.
No, it's not black.
Brown smudge.
No, it's red.
Please don't come here and talk about the painting.
I like to take them.
How many? What are people doing in this, do you think?
Playing a fellow.
Do you like this painting? And what are the people doing? What else can you see in the painting? What do you think is happening in it?
The boys eating on the table.
Do you like the colours? Do you like this painting, Fern?
I like the colours of this painting.
Really? What colours can you see in the painting, Fern?
I can see red.
Red, and any other colours?
Yellow.
Yes. What do you think what do you think that lady's doing? Fern, can you see the statue in the painting?
That lady's saying, don't play that poor piano.
So you think that man's playing the piano, but the lady doesn't like it?
Yeah.
And then what are the men wearing the funny clothes here and the table? What do you think they're talking about?
I think they're talking about unicorns.
They're talking about unicorns.
Landscapes, it's all about the mistakes and how you did them well. I fell for you in the summer, and that was a bummer because you left in the spring. But don't sigh, nothing's gonna take you away from me, girl. You were there all along. An old boy on a park bench, thinking in the past tense, looking for the word. I'll wash my face tomorrow, and for the days that follow, I do it all again. But don't sigh, nothing's gonna take you away from me, girl. You were there all along. It's all about the mistakes and how you did them well. But don't sigh, nothing's gonna take you away from me, girl. Don't sigh, nothing's gonna take you away from me, girl. Don't sigh, nothing's gonna take you away from me, girl. Nothing's gonna take you away from me, girl. It's the outro chair. Somebody's sitting
Yes. Outdoors. I think I've forgotten the question.
The song is called Sex, Step and Landscape. So if you can do sex in a landscape.
In a landscape, outdoors. It's not a story though.
We'll just
I had sex in an outdoor environment in the shed, and somebody, you know, as it was happening, somebody was walking towards me and this beautiful girl, and it was quite early on, and
in the relationship.
Yes, obviously, and then there was a coat on the floor. You don't want it to go too much information. Oh, and then the dog interrupted for a moment because the dog came towards. There was like holes in the shed. It was like a really run down shed, so you like see through the holes. So we weren't quite sure whether only the dog could see us or the dog sort of came, knew we were in there, and was like sniffing around. Luckily, it didn't start barking because if the owner had gone up to the shed, it would have seen two people. You know, I can't say rude words. Having sex in the landscape, in a shed. It wasn't even a shed, it was like a ruin of a shed.
A ruin of a shed?
Like let's a say, barn? Yeah. Well, it wasn't a barn. It wasn't. Alright, let's say it was a barn. Oh, another.
Romantic.
It was a combine harvester as well once. It's quite landscapey. That was interrupted.
Was that? How? That was the same story or difference?
Now you're going back into like a whole. Like, I think I was much more adventurous in. Landscape sex when I was younger. Maybe it's something I should explore. My tips for having sex in the landscape would be I think if you want to have sex in the landscape, then you should probably choose somewhere with a bit of shelter from the elements and bring a coat that's large enough to create a blanket situation. Avoid shit. Like if you're going into a field, don't go anywhere near shit. Landscapes.
What makes up a beautiful landscape?
For me, very different from most people, I would imagine. The most exciting, like beautiful landscapes. You just the little environment. I think more of like, okay, landscapes. I'm not really thinking of landscapes. I'm thinking of just like spaces, like places that you go to, where. You feel like this is beautiful. They can be outdoors, they could be classed as landscape, but you would happen upon them. You wouldn't choose to go there. I think it's better if you haven't chosen to go there. It's like an accidental landscape. But I think I'm definitely really attracted to people in places. So if I'm in the middle of nowhere, I really like throwing, you know, getting some people in there to make it like really visually exciting. That's when it becomes interesting. Then people in landscapes makes it more beautiful. Or, yeah, makes it just more interesting.
Death. Sex, death and landscape. You've done sex.
Yeah, done landscape, sort of.
You've done sex in landscapes.
That was good.
Can you try and make people feel better about it?
About death? I doubt it, but... let's try and be upbeat about death. I think some people find it very useful to think about it coming towards them and like getting on with stuff if it's a motivator. But also, I really quite like the idea of death anyway. I've always been really fine about it. I'm a much bigger fan, even though I love people. I really like animals and nature and things. And I think my plan is, if I can choose when I'm dying, I'd really like to be able to see nature around me. There's like a painter that started painting flowers. That's like another story. When he only realised why people bring flowers in when you're like dying or really ill. Because it's like if you have flowers around you, they're just so beautiful. You just remind how stupid all your kind of like human thoughts are. You just look at these creations. You're like, wow, this is, you know, beauty. And flowers. The most beautiful thing about flowers is they die, right? I think that might be a Francis Bacon quote, or he used that quote anyway. But I think the beauty in life is the fact that things die, you know. So like, you know, if I was dying and I was like seeing some little birds flying around, they don't live very long, birds. But they're having a great, you know, they're just beautiful things. And I think if you just don't get so worked up about how important you are as a person, and just be like, you know what, be a bit more like an animal about it and just be like, well, you know, just get on with the life bit. And, you know, when you die, it's just like a nice rest. You don't have to. People always like, oh my god, like that feeling of dying. I mean, I obviously I'm not gonna die tomorrow, so I don't want to sound insensitive. It's probably you know, personally, I don't worry about my own death because I just feel right now, you know, if I died tomorrow, I'd just be like, oh, really well rested. Don't need to do anything the next day. You're dead.
James Walker.
Love. I rode down the hill like a ball about nothing at all, and the wildest mountains seemed suddenly small. Cause love, did it ever feel like you fell from the sky? And no one asked why, and everything moved like a young butterfly. Cause love. You can't be a runner with a broken toe. You can't paint a painting like Van Gogh. You can't pronounce everything right, you know. But don't die, Curie. You can't move a mountain in a beat. You can't find the truth of everyone you meet. You can't kiss a stranger in the street. But don't die, Curie.